Twitter has their own tag, the Twitter Universal Website Tag. And in this video, I'm going to show you how you can install it via Google Tag Manager. Now, my name is Julian, and you're watching Measure School. All right, today our journey starts in our demo shop, where we already have Google Tag Manager installed, and we now want to add to this our Twitter ads tracking. So obviously you would need to have a Twitter account. We have one here at Measure School, so follow if you want to stay up to date with everything that we do. And connected to this account is our Twitter ads account. Now, just like in Facebook, you can get your Twitter pixel by going to Tools and then Conversion Tracking. And here we have our Universal Website Tag that needs to be installed. And you can view the code instructions right here. Here's the code that we need to install through Google Tag Manager. But really all that we need is this little part of our Twitter Universal Website Tag, which will identify us to Twitter. So let's copy that and go over to Google Tag Manager. And here we're gonna create a new tag. This will be our Twitter ads tag. It's our universal tag, which we're gonna deploy on all pages. As a tag configuration, we can choose a template here from Twitter, which is already in the system, Twitter Universal Website Tag. And we put in our pixel ID, which was these few characters from our pixel. Now we can select different events, but since we are deploying this on all our pages, just go with page view and not put in anything specific right here. Let's choose our trigger, which is our all pages trigger, and save this. Refresh our preview and debug mode, go back to our page, refresh that. And we can see we have our Twitter ads universal pixel or tag deployed. Now there is actually a Chrome extension that you can install in order to check whether this was fired correctly. And this is what I have installed here, the Twitter Pixel Helper. And it shows us that the Twitter Pixel has fired successfully. Unfortunately, there is no way in Twitter to see any kind of debug information or if this pixel was sent over correctly, at least not in real time. What you would need to do is either set up a new conversion event with the universal website tag in order to see if conversions are tracked correctly. And you can specify, like in the Facebook pixel as well, if you want to filter this down to an exact URL. Or you would need to actually set up an audience. Again, you would need to utilize the website visitor collection tag here, which is based on the universal website tag, which we have just installed, and deploy this on the page and then see whether data is coming through, but this can take a while till the audience needs to be populated by your website tag. So no real way to verify this within Twitter ads directly. Our best bet is to utilize our Twitter Pixel Helper. Now that we have verified this, at least with the Pixel Helper and our debug console, let's go ahead and actually publish a version by going back into our Google Tag Manager account, clicking on Submit, and giving our version a name, and then publishing this so it goes live to our users. All right, so there you have it. This is how you can install the Twitter Universal Website Tag onto your website with the help of Google Tag Manager. Now, you saw a lot more options within the Google Tag Manager interface on how you can configure this tag. I will just leave it up to you to try this out and build your conversions or your audiences of this pixel. I'd love to hear from you. If you want to have a closer description on this whole feature of how to track conversions, and let me know in the comments down below and we could do another tutorial on it. Otherwise, why not give us a thumbs up if you like this video and also subscribe to our channel right over there because we bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.